مادة اللغة الإنجليزية لثالث الثانوي الأدبي، كتاب الأنشطة، الوحدة الثالثة بعنوان Lifestyles، الدرس التاسع بعنوان New Ways and Old، من الصفحة 52 وحتى الصفحة 56، تقديم مبادرة الضوء بصوت زينب شاهين. Reading Section. Question number one. Before you read the article below, match these words and phrases with their meanings. You may need to check your ideas in a dictionary. Number A, artifact. The answer is number one, an object of cultural or historical interest. Number B, skilled. The answer is number four, having a special ability or talent. Number C, artisan. The answer is number five, worker in a skilled trade, usually making items by hand. Number D, Bronze Age. The answer is number three, a period of prehistory when weapons and tools were commonly made of bronze. Number E, ornate. The answer is number two, intricately decorated with complex patterns or constructions. Question number two. Read this article about some of the traditional crafts in Syria and answer these questions. The text. Traditional crafts in Aleppo. Syria has undergone a period of modernization in the last few years, with new buildings and improved transportation services in its cities. Yet it remains an ancient land that has enjoyed involvement and interaction with many different civilizations over the last 10,000 years. Syria's historical importance and its crucial location at the crossroads of several ancient trading routes mean that a wide variety of crafts have developed. However, the fast pace of globalization is threatening the skilled local artisans who strive to preserve these wonderful traditions. As cheaper, mass-produced goods are imported from abroad, it's important that people are made aware of these traditional crafts and those who practice them. In the city of Aleppo, there's a market dedicated to protecting handmade copper goods to ensure that this ancient craft doesn't vanish. Copper artifacts have been discovered all over the region. Some of these artifacts date to the Bronze Age, around 3000 BCE. Historians have identified a number of uses for the material, including weaponry, jewelry, and ornaments. These items give us information about the way ancient peoples lived and interacted. The Aleppo Craftsmen Union is trying to revive this world-famous industry by establishing a training center and promoting the local and regional trade of copper products. There are several processes involved in the production of copper goods, including cutting, welding, and ornamentation. The metal then has to be thoroughly cleaned before it is suitable for sale. Currently, only a small handful of artisans continue to practice this craft. However, local people are being encouraged to learn the skills needed to make ornate copper items which will be suitable for commercial sale. Number A. Why is there such a variety of historical crafts in Syria? The answer is because of its long history of interaction with different civilizations and because of its location at the crossroads of several ancient trading routes. Number B. How are these traditional crafts being threatened? The answer is by globalization, by cheaper mass-produced goods from abroad. Number C. Why are copper artifacts useful to historians? The answer is they date to the Bronze Age, around 3000 BCE, and give historians information about the way ancient people lived. Number D. Why is it important to preserve the traditions mentioned below? The answer is up to you. Question number 3. Read the article again and answer these questions. A. Which of these statements about traditional Syrian crafts isn't true? Number A. Syria has been an important trading center for several millennia. Number B. Nothing is being done to encourage traditional Syrian craftsmanship. Number C. Local artisans are threatened by increasing globalization. The answer is number B. B. Which of these statements about copper isn't true? Number A. Copper artifacts have been found in the region dating to around 3000 BCE. Number B. Craftsmen must be taught special skills to create remarkable copper items. Number C. The craft of making ornate copper goods has been totally destroyed by the modern world. The answer is number C. Question number 4. Complete sentences from A to C with words from this list. The words are evidence, trade, civilizations, traditional, preservation. Number A. Syria has been a center of space in the region for thousands of years. The word is trait. Number B. Several organizations are now helping to support the space of spacecrafts. The words are preservation and traditional. Number C. Copper artifacts are used by historians as space of past space. The words are evidence and civilizations. Question number 5. What do you think are the most important traditional uses of copper? In what ways have modern products replaced copper? The answer is up to you. And now let's move to vocabulary section. Question number 1. Complete these statements using words from the box. The words are blow, percussion, pluck, wood, strum. Number A. A flute. You have to space. The answer is you have to blow it. Number B. A guitar. You can either space. The answer is you can either pluck or strum it. Number C. An oud and a violin. They are both space. The answer is they are both made of wood. Number D. A tabla. This is a space. The answer is this is a percussion instrument. Question number 2. Complete these sentences using the correct form of these idioms. The idioms are blow your or his own trumpet, change your or his tune, drum something into someone, face the music. Number A. He's been telling lies to so many people, eventually they'll find out and he'll have to space. The answer is face the music. Number B. I can't stand the kind of big-headed person who space all the time. The answer is blows his own trumpet. Number C. He was against the idea of a holiday in Greece, but he space when he found out how cheap the flight was. The answer is change your or his tune. Number D. The importance of knowing the difference between right and wrong is usually space children by their parents at a very early age. The answer is drummed into. Grammar section. Having things done. Question number 1. Complete these sentences using the correct form of have something done. You may also have to think of a verb. Number A. I couldn't repair my computer myself. I had to space by computer experts. The answer is have it repaired. Number B. We didn't build our own house. We space by a local construction company. The answer is had it built. Number C. Brides rarely make their own wedding dresses. They space by specialist dressmakers. The answer is have them made. Number D. People don't service their cars themselves. They space professionally 2 or 3 times a year. The answer is have them serviced. Number E. I've got a really bad toothache, so I'm going to the dentist this afternoon. I might have to space. The answer is have a tooth taken out, or you can say have a tooth filled. Number F. She tried mending her glasses, but she couldn't. She had to space by the optician she had bought them from. The answer is have them mended. Number G. Do you like these photographs of our family? We space by a local photographer. The answer is had it taken. Question number 2. Now answer these questions, starting with no. Number A. Did you redecorate the flat yourself? The answer is no. We decorated. Number B. Did you plant the trees in your garden yourself? The answer is no, we had them planted. Number C. Are you going to service your own car? The answer is no, I am going to have it serviced. Number D. Will you be able to test your own eyesight? The answer is no, I'll have to have it tested for me. Question number 3. What do the words in bold in the text on page 52 refer to? Number A. It's ITS. The answer is it's refers to Syria. The sentence was Syria has undergone a period of modernization in the last few years with new buildings and improved transportation services in its cities. Number B. Them. The answer is them refers to traditional crafts. The sentence was it's important that people are made aware of these traditional crafts and those who practice them. Number C. It. The answer is it refers to metal. The sentence was the metal then has to be thoroughly cleaned before it is suitable for sale. Writing section. Writing a biography. Question number 1. Use the notes below to write a brief biography of the Syrian calligrapher Muhammad Abdullah Ghannoum. The notes are name Muhammad Abdullah Ghannoum, place and date of birth Damascus 1949, profession calligrapher. Education, Arts Faculty at the University of Damascus. Exhibitions, Kuwait, Doha, Cairo, Beirut, London, Berlin, Madrid. Achievements, honored at a number of international festivals including Kuwait and UAE. A member of the Artists Union, CAP, took part in the International Exhibition of Calligraphy, which aims to popularize and promote the ancient art of calligraphy. Writing the biography is up to you. Question number 2. Write a brief biography of a young person you know well. Include some of this information: name and age, appearance, family background and education, occupation and specialty, hobbies and interests, other important information. Also, writing this biography is up to you. نهاية التسجيل.